I go out of bed.
Sometimes wanting to push a little bit, you know.
I love the 80s, I love the thing that we're talking about.
I used to,
again,
I love changing the way I look all the time, but so I'll see what they say.
For them to interpret what we had in our heads and actually put that on paper is amazing. It's just gonna look wicked.
Hello, you're here at the X Factor Glamour Shoot. It's very loud because that guy over there is blowing his leaves.
I feel a bit naked without the hat. Within arm's reach, so if I need to...
I'm so excited.
Bum, bum, bum.
You look amazing.
Not
you're the best looking with the bell of me.
Oh, don't tell the other girls that. I'm not ready.
Jen, you're the best looking of the bell of me. We're going to do our group glamour shots. Strike a few poses, like such as...
Cardell in a tunnel making standing still look incredibly easy.
She looks amazing. She looks like something out of Vogue. 5, 6, 7, 8.
Here we are, One Direction, waiting for our makeup to be done, waiting for the photo shoot.
So with One Direction, what we've done, we've taken a bit of a Burberry film. We wanted to keep that real nice young spirit going on, so we brought a bit of a London style edge into their look.
I think we're trying to go for a really current, fashionable look to impress the ladies especially.
They've all got amazing hair, so we're really, really lucky, and they've really embraced the ideas that we had and taken that all on board. So again, with the boys, it's really nice to have a little bit of a stylized element within the looks that we're going to be doing on the hair through the shows.
I think we're trying to have it so that we look like a band, but we still have our own identity, so we have kind
keep
of
individual
little twists on each on the look, so that we are still all like individual.
I was brown with stupid highlights, but now I've changed to bleached blonde, which hurt very much. Burnt my scalp.
Got everyone kind of sat around and stood on boxes and things like that. It was really good looking together. And it's a nice new experience being in a fashion shoot.
The set for the photo is just like, it's rock star inspired. It's amazing, it's fabulous, just great to be a part of it.
Gotta keep my head held high.
The Sainsbury's Tri Team are back to turn up the heat in the X Factor kitchen. Face the chop. Who has the will to grill? Kitchen sink chaos. Microwave madness. Oven door drama. Zoe McLean. Helen Broadhurst. Sally Craik. Liz Conlon.
If this goes wrong, this could be the end of my dream so far.
It's time.
Concentrate in the kitchen.
To face. The Moussaka.
Yeah.
Everyone to this year's X Factor. My name's Liz from Sainsbury's Tri Team, and I am joined this year by
Niall,
Nicola,
Harry,
Liam,
Louis, and Helen.
The task for these guys is to make three trifles, three variations. So, guys, I hope you're good at your desserts. If not, we're going to show you what to do. And basically, it's time to get cooking while they go over there and see what Zoe and the team are doing.
I'm Zoe from the Tri Team.
I'm Sally from the Tri Team.
And we are the Savoury Team.
Are we the Savoury Team? Oh, yes, we are.
The are going to be making a fantastic shepherd's pie. Who we've got here?
I'm John Adelaide, and today I'm a veggie master.
He's doing the vegetarian.
We're up by doing with the turkey stuffers.
We're going to spread jam in between the layers, and then we're going to use that to line the dish.
Rub the peel in the apple.
Cut, that's called the pith there. Can you see all that white there?
Yeah.
That's called pith. So you're cutting down that, and then you're cutting down that one there, and you take that second one out.
Right. I don't take any care of my apples, but I mean, it can stick now, isn't it?
That is strong onion.
I'm just cutting the potatoes to put in here so that they can boil, which will then like make it a mash.
Just take that and just crush it.
I'm going to put in here now is some of our baby leaf spinach.
Cook my apples. Going to lob it on.
I'm sure it will taste delicious.
Yeah. This is going to be the fabulous topping for the turkey one we're doing. We're going to actually mix this lovely tasty different stuffing, which we've already mixed up, with mashed potatoes. It's going to make a really unusual, savoury topping.
It's going to rough it up to add some texture to it.
Excellent.
When it goes in the oven.
Oh, crispy on top. It looks beautiful, that.
It's going to be fed well. I'm going to come out fat, actually.
You're not going to come out fat. Eating lentils,
that was the plan. Why did we go audition for this show?
Don't you wish
your
girlfriend like me?
Can I just say it might be a very long 10 weeks that we've got here in the house. A long 10 weeks. It will be.
This means a lot to me right now. If this goes wrong, this could be the end of my dream so far.
Look at that bad boy.
We've just had a brilliant blast this afternoon. I'm speaking on behalf of all of us. Yeah. You are a really lively bunch, which is fantastic. But I hope that it's just given you a bit of an insight into what you can expect each week from us, each time coming. So do come join in, see what we're going to be making. But just, I think you've done a fantastic job today. Yeah, and there's just one thing left to do, which is to tuck in and see what you think of what you make.
Now, quesadillas are using all these wraps. So, about 8 wraps there, and the boys here, Niall's doing the spring onions, and we've got the red pepper here, and the yellow pepper, and some grated cheese over there. And what we're going to do is we're going to mix them all together, pop it all on one quesadilla,
come together,
put it in the frying pan, start it off on a hot heat, put another wrap on top, and then turn it over. And all the filling inside melts. It's absolutely gorgeous. And then you can cut them up and serve them as like little starters or serve them at parties.
Get them all together.
Right, put some cheese in. Not all of it, not about half of it. And give it a stir. And you can do what Jamie does and use your hands and give it a good stir.
Oh, yes.
Jamie Oliver always uses his hands.
Yeah, no, you don't use your hands.
I do.
Are they washed?
Yeah.
Get all mixed together. All
right, Jamie Oliver, all right. I should make my own cookery book.
Right, we're going to stick this in a pan and we're going to put
fry it up
on the cooker and we're going to fry it up and see what happens.
Right, we're going to start cutting the ears off. Okay, so we'll put that in the pan, get it on a hot heat. Hold that. And then with your hands again, like Jamie Oliver, you're
going to... Jamie Oliver.
Just a minute, I'm going to get got started to let it sizzle first. Just sizzle. Can you hear it sizzle, yeah? Sizzling.
Not yet.
It heated up, yeah, it's nice and hot.
Yeah, it's just a quick...
Yeah. Have you done this before?
Never, ever, ever.
Right. Oh gosh,
sizzling.
Right, put some of this in.
What do I do?
Hands in. Just pour it on. Throw it on.
Where? In the middle?
Yeah. Anywhere. Spread it out in a minute, a bit more. Right. And we've cut everything
up really small because
then
it cooks really
evenly. That's fine.
Yeah.
Now spread it out with your hand.
We'd like to put
these
in the oven now.
Same
did this
as well, didn't you?
Yeah.
Well, I did most of it. You did. That's it. Put it on top and press it down. Keep it like that.
How do you flip it?
Do you want to flip it?
No.
Come on.
No. Alright.
Take it off the hot.
See, I'm left handed. What was the filling for?
Well, we're experimenting. Sticky. You hold
there.
Yeah!
Here we
are! Wow! He's turned his cafe over without filling it.
Yeah, look at that.
Woo-hoo. Gordon Ramsay, shut up shop. Now that's how I roll.
Who made these?
Uh-oh.
Watch out for any bits of bright blonde hair.
We're going to finish this up, boys, aren't we? Don't you think?
I think you've cooked so much.
You're the man!
Who are you? Who are you?
Making artists super mega stars overnight. Power. That's
how we do that.
To be Simon Cowell.
He would be Mr. Universe, I reckon.
Yeah, Mr. Universe.
All seeing, all knowing, all powerful.
To rule the world.
Barbados.
I reckon Miami.
Miami.
Doncaster.
Caribbean.
Live from the contestant's house, the Talk Q&A. And your host, Louis Tomlinson!
Thank you! Yes! Hey! It's Louis Tomlinson! Pick a card, any card. Pick one!
I'm going!
Don't read it yet! This question's from Megan. Who spends the longest time in front of the mirror?
Zayn!
The answer's Zayn.
It's not true.
Zayn Malik from One Direction.
Who wants to pick the next card?
Oh.
You? Okay. This one's from...
Jaden Jones.
Who's your secret celebrity crush?
Ooh. Go, Joe. Jump it.
That's a rushing.
I'm gonna have to rush you, quicker, please!
Orlando Bloom!
Orlando Bloom! Zayn! Pick a card!
Zayn!
Just one, not two!
Okay.
Anna Thompson says, if you could be an animal, what animal would you be? Zayn?
A bunny rabbit.
Probably a lion.
Zayn says a lion! Who's next?
Me!
Niall!
Oh, no.
Oh, you got...
Her name is Lucy Driver. Who's the messiest person in the finalist house?
Louis Tomlinson! Hey.
Wait, you gotta... Okay. Another question, anyone? Cher, would you like? Rachel Williams says, who do you think is your biggest competition?
Ooh!
Ooh in the crowd, please! Ooh in the crowd!
Ooh!
Wagner!
Lord Shaq!
A strong competitor!
Lord Shaq!
Lord Shaq!
Silence, please! We're on to the last card! It's from Sarah!
Ashurst.
What do you do in your free time? No explicit information,
fake
please.
Fake tan.
I put on fake tan on my face and talk a lot of...
This was the Talk Q&A. Tune in next week. I've been your host, Louis Tomlinson. Yeah, come on. Get off me, you crazy people. Get off me.
Hi guys, One Direction, the hot new boy band. How are you all feeling about Saturday?
I think we're all pretty excited. We're doing quite a big song. A lot of people know it, and we're just hoping we can do it justice.
Okay. How are you, obviously you performed by Louis Louis and Simon. How are you all sort of getting on? Have you all bonded already?
I think it's at the start it was kind of hard, just being thrown together. We've had to get to know each other in a short space of time, know what our likes and dislikes are, but now we get on like a house on fire. I mean, we're living together now and we have just a good laugh every day, and every day gets better.
Are you looking forward to working with Simon like every week?
Yeah, we are looking forward to working with Simon. I think you always get to hear from him, and he's always on the phone giving you his opinions and stuff. So I think working even more hand on hand with him is going to be brilliant, because he's the pinnacle of the business, really.
And you guys are all like living together now. Like, how are you getting on? I can see you like messing around a bit down here. Are you really sort of good mates now?
It's brilliant. I think it's great. Yeah. It's like four, you know, five lads the same age. Living in the same house, it's ideal, really. It's all right, isn't it?
Yeah.
What do you think, lads, eh?
Yeah. One big sleepover in the house.
Oh, yes. Are you all behaving yourselves in the house? Because I think you must be the youngest.
Yeah, well, we're behaving ourselves, but at the same time, we don't really get time to have a joke because we're always so busy. And then when we do get back to the house, we're also tired. And
everyone's too tired to put up with our jokes. Time, so we just get...
Are you guys sort of going to break the curse of the groups? Is it this the year?
Yeah, well, I think we want to break the mold and be the first group to win the X Factor. And I think that's our main aim, obviously, to win the X Factor.
That's what we're here for.
That's what we're here for, yeah.
Presumably it's going to be pretty tough to impress. Louis, the sort of king of boy bands, as much as Westlife and Boyzone. And is he the one you're really trying to impress on the panel?
We're trying to impress all the judges equally.
Yeah. Definitely. I mean, Louis knows what boy bands are about, and he's worked with them, but Simon's always involved with boy bands and stuff as well, so we just want to impress all of them.
And the lady, Cheryl.
I mean, she's in a girl band, so she knows what being in the band's all about.
And you've got tons of fans already on the Digital Spy forums, and they're all going mad about you, they're mad on you on Twitter. Are you enjoying that, all the screaming girls and stuff?
It's alright, isn't it? It's not too bad.
It's pretty average. Obviously, again, you know, we're impressing the judges, we also need to impress the public, and if they're putting up comments on Digital Spy, you know, that's great. The more fans, the more votes.
Yeah, we really appreciate every fan we get. I mean, it's amazing just to see all these people online, on the way to the studio. Sometimes we get girls on the side of the road in their cars waving at us and stuff. And every time you get that, it's just a little bit of appreciation for you, and it's wonderful.
It's if you're on your way to somewhere and you've had to get up early, you go into the studio and you're tired. You look on your phone. It gives you a bit of a confidence when people are saying so much how much they like the group and stuff. So.
I read in the magazine yesterday that one of you was wearing a golden thong in the house. Well, why was that? What was the need? What was the requirement for that?
Well, my friend bought me for Christmas, and I don't know. I just do a manly stroll every now and again. Let everyone know the man of the house is.
It's gonna look stupid, whatever, isn't it?
I was worried about my hair straight away. I mean, it wasn't so much they cut it off, but they just stole it wrong. So I just got a coat of Simon's. So they changed it straight away.
I think I got a better haircut than what I had before.
Why wouldn't it happen?
Because it's a bit of a mess.
It cost him £30, that hat. Going for £30.
I'd have to say Cheryl Cole is unbelievable. When we saw her the other day, got a kiss on the cheek. Best moment of my life.
I see like Ollie only Lewis for me. Which one more?
Frankie Sanford. Saturdays.
It's just perfection.
I like that we're all talking about girls and hair, by the way. There's not been any mention of singing yet. Are you all looking forward to Saturday?
We like to sing.
Yeah, we're actually singers.
No, we really are looking forward to Saturday. I mean, it's going to be a lot of pressure on us because it's only our second performance as a group.
We're all literally best mates. We're going really, really.
I mean, we have the odd argument, but that's helpful. It's just getting things, you know, we're at a stage where we do get on so well, we can bring stuff up and we can have conflicts. And then it's
Mal farts. In fact, my sleep. But you fart all the time.
Yes.
Boy band One Direction join me now. Lovely to see all of you. Really good to see you. You look so cute. And Liam, if I can ask you, do you actually feel that you've all come together as a group? Because of course you were kind of put together by Simon, weren't you?
Yeah, I mean it's been kind of hard to start off with because we were just sort of thrown together, and it's been such a short space of time to get to know each of the lads. But we all get on so well, and we're all living together now, and it's amazing. Really
good.
Oh,
that's really good. And it must be extra special for you because this is second time lucky, isn't it?
Yeah, second time lucky.
Exactly, because you nearly got there last year, and this is you through, so it's absolutely fantastic. Harry, you are just a baby. You're only 16 years old.
I am, yeah.
Away from home, I hope you're behaving yourself in the house. What's it like there? It must be really good fun.
It's always pretty loud. I mean, you have your messy people and you have your tiny people, but... It's really good living with all the boys, and I miss my mum a little bit.
I bet you do. I bet you miss your mum looking after you, and miss your mum's home cooking and all of that. Who do you think, both of you, who do you think are the biggest threat to One Direction? Who are you kind of looking out for that's just maybe a wee bit too good?
I think it's going to have to be Matt Carden.
Yeah, he's an amazing, amazing singer, really
his
nice
vocal,
guy as well.
His vocal is just quality, and it's so consistent that you know you can throw anything at him and he'll perfect it. So.
On the first night we were in the house, we all sat around with a guitar and Matt was singing, and it was amazing, really, really good.
It must be good fun actually in the house with you all singing and performing and getting to know one another, but of course... Saturday, a big, big night for all of you. It's the live final. I mean, you must be so excited about it, but inevitably a bit nervous as well.
Well, there's a lot of pressure on us. I mean, there's going to be millions of people watching, and we've never done any live performing before. It's going to only be our second performance, so we're all on edge a bit, but we're so excited and we're just ready for it now.
Absolutely, that's biting talk and that's what we like. Listen, good luck to all of you, and I know you've got all the press descending on you in a couple of minutes, so just be careful. and thank you for joining us, and good luck on Saturday, boys.
Thanks very much.
Aww,
see ya.
Thank you. They do really
Hi, we're One Direction, and this is our video diary.
You can come back here every week to find out what we've been up to, how we're feeling, and everything that's going on.
Yeah, what the curly-haired guy said.
Right, what's happened this week then? We've moved into the X Factor house, which is really exciting. We've been waiting ages for this, and that's the moment.
Long time.
Yeah, a very long time. We got a decent room in the house. It's not the biggest room.
We got the worst room in
we
the house.
We could have got a bigger room.
And we got bunk beds.
We're not complaining because... We're all having a laugh. We're just enjoying ourselves. We're
sharing a room with four of our best friends in the world.
We're the four best friends.
We've been practicing hard. It's a good song. We like the song, don't we?
Yeah, we do.
Really like the song.
I think we've had a lot of preparation now, and it's just the time's ticking by, and we just can't wait to get on this stage and share what we can do as a group.
Yeah, we really hope you guys like it as well.
And if you've got any questions to ask us, just leave them below and we'll get right back to you.
So about, there, just about
here. Around here. Right. See you guys.
Bye.
Bye. We love you. Bye. You ever wondered what happens in the contestant's house in the run-up to the life? Well, that is lucky because right now it's time for lights. Ooh. Camera. Ooh. An unseen action.
Morning, guys. It's looking to. It is 7:45 and it's Saturday.
No.
Come on, you guys. Come on.
3, 2, 1.
In a wild card all week, I've had to walk around like all week like that. So once it's been revealed, it's gonna be great.
When you get given that no and you get set back into like normality, you sort of realise how much you actually did want it.
Tonight's the night the divas return.
We're just keeping an eye on the very pretty dancers. It's a hard job, but I think someone's got to do it.
I've been watching people and getting very nervous. I'm quite excited to get going there.
Give me a B, give me an E.
We're going live in 1 minute.
We're going to enjoy ourselves, just perform and do what we love to do. And action.
How are you doing, Jordan, cameraman Jordan?
Give us your best funny face.
I don't even actually look like a monkey.
Hello.
Huh?
Reading your nails, girl.
Yeah. Had a bit of an accident.
I am the single politician who fight for the rights of the women in need.
I'm asking everyone to do their best funny face. What is your best funny face?
My best funny face?
Yeah. I'm excited.
You won't be human. You can't get nervous.
Who is the youth thing?
I am Niall.
And I'm Zane.
And we've all just got ready for the show. This is what we're wearing. We've all gone for our own individual styles. We were told that we could pick whatever we wanted to wear. Louis obviously gone with the knitted polo top.
Mm-hmm.
Very. He's obviously gone with the grey trousers with the.
Oh, hang on.
With the elastic bottoms. And obviously the nice little tassel shoes.
Loafers.
Niall, however, has gone for the very nice vintage denim shirt. Fits very tight to his strong physique. Also with some nice, he's working the grey jeans that do elasticate at the bottom with some nice All Saints style boots. He's pulling off a great denim, grey and boot look.
And I think you should both describe mine.
Shall we? Right, okay. Do you want top off or bottom off now?
I'll take the top off.
Let's do this.
Yes. So, as we can clearly see here with Zane, he's gone with his metallic silver necklace.
Metallic, it's actually silver.
Ooh. Ooh. Yeah, oh, sorry.
Real silver, not metallic.
He's got a vest top on with a hole in it.
£3 off, that was.
Yeah. Because I'm cool.
Yeah.
Right. He's gone with the checked red, blue,
Charlie Chalk's kind of shirt.
Charlie Chalk's kind of shirt. Yeah.
Thanks for that.
He's got half tucked in, half out, like the David Beckham look. And then
He's gone for a nice black kind of charcoal belt here.
No, it's actually green.
Someone's clearly colourblind. He's also gone for some kind of. Do you want to see these green as well? Greeny grey jeans with some quality boots there. Hopefully, our fans like what we're wearing.
One Direction styled themselves and stuck to their rough and ready combo of denim and worker boots, except for Louis, who injected some peppy chic with a woolen polo shirt and Topshop loafers.
One Direction! 100% believe a group will win this year. Genuinely the best groups we've ever had in this competition. And I've got them.
Here they are. Please welcome the X Factor finalists. The groups. The girls. The boys. And the over 28s. Congratulations, one and all, but this is it. 16 acts, any one of them could win the X Factor, but tonight they've got one shot as they sing live for your votes. After the break, we kick off this Super Saturday as the contest gets underway. Don't miss a moment. We'll see you in a minute. Groups and songs.
Okay, last act up tonight. Get ready, it's One Direction.
Decided to put you through to the judges.
I've gone with my heart. You're through.
Yeah! Being through to live shows is absolutely incredible.
I'm Louis, I'm 18, I'm from Doncaster.
I'm Harry, I'm 16, I'm from Cheshire.
I'm Niall, I'm 17, and from Mullingar in Ireland.
I'm Liam, I'm 17, and I'm from Wolverhampton.
I'm Zane, I'm 17, and I'm from Bradford.
You wouldn't actually connect this band normally with this song, but strangely, it works.
When we were practicing the song with Sarban, the vocal coach, I was off time with the music.
Are you good when they come in?
Yeah.
You guys help them out?
You stop. Obviously, I can't afford to make a mistake like that on the live show because that one mistake could ruin it and end it for us all, and obviously we don't want that.
These guys really need to step up and deliver. It's a lot of pressure.
One
direction.
I used to rule the world. Seas would arise when I gave the word. Now in the morning I sleep alone. Sweep the streets I used to walk.
Your own, and I love that the band is gelling. Even though Simon's going to claim he put this band together, it was my idea originally, Simon.
It was my idea.
It's
not your idea.
Boys, I think potentially you could be the next big boy band. But you have a lot of work to do, you know. And I'm not sure about the styling. Did you have a stylist, or was it you?
Idea it was, because I wasn't there, but you look like you fit together, like you're the perfect band. That song was fantastic, and you did make it your own. I wasn't thinking of Coldplay then. That was a perfect pop band performance.
I have to agree with Danny. You look like you were meant to be together as a group. You look fantastic. You've got all the ingredients for the perfect pop band. I reckon the girls at home will be going crazy for you, but you do need a little bit more time to develop as a group. That's all, just a little bit more time.
Well, regarding your role in putting the group together, Louis, we'll rewind the tapes on that one.
Yeah, please do.
You guys came together because your boot camp auditions weren't good enough, but you were too good to throw away. We took a risk, and I've got to tell you, what was so impressive about that was, because it's a big leap going on this stage, when you started to screw up, one of you at the end, Liam stepped in, you brought it back together. That's what bands do. I've got to tell you, and regarding the whole styling issue, Louis, I don't want to style this band because I don't know how to style a band like this. We asked the band to do whatever they wanted to do. I'm not going to interfere. They're going to do it their way. It was brilliant, guys.
Yeah, Louis, with the greatest respect, how do you know what 18-year-olds should be wearing? Come on, man. Listen, we have to go straight to numbers, guys. Just a very quick word. You loved it, right?
Yeah, it was the best experience of all our lives. So.
Good for you, boys. All right. Oh, no, 161, 113. If you want One Direction to go onwards and upwards in this competition, get calling when lines open. And to download their performance, itv.com/X Factor for the details. It's One Direction. Good.
right. 13 on the end for One Direction and 14 for Wagner. 15 rather for Aidan and Tracy, 16 at the end of the number. Go. Now that was a show. The battle is on, the countdown has started, and this year the acts need your votes like never before, because I have some news for you. Tomorrow night in the results show, it is a double elimination. Not one, but two acts will be leaving the competition for good. You have 24 hours and counting to save your favourite. Plus, the champ is back. Last year's X Factor winner, live on this stage, Joe McKelvey is coming home. And we have a worldwide superstar exclusive performing live tomorrow night. Right here is Usher. How about that? There we go. Get those shades on, Usher. Get yourself to itv.com/X Factor for all the latest details, how to download all of tonight's performances. Turn over to ITV2 for the Extra Factor with Connie, where the judges and the acts are taking your calls live. We are back with the results tomorrow night, 8 o'clock, ITV1. You have a great night. Thanks so much for watching. God bless. Take care. Bye-bye.
In a mole in the house. Oh, yes. And sorry, guys, but this isn't a member of the paparazzis. This isn't a member of the tabloid press. It's one of your very own who's been spying. Someone you live with, someone in your midst, has been snooping around and being a traitor. Was it you, Aidan? Where is it? Was it you?
No.
Are you lying?
No.
Oh, well, who was it then? Have a look at this.
Oh, message from Connie. Hello, Harry. I want you to do some secret investigating into who is the vainest contestant. Good luck and don't get caught. Connie, mission accepted.
Coast is clear.
I reckon those eyelashes are Cher's. Disgusting. Katie Waisel often spends hours pinning things to her hair. Here is evidence. Pearls.
I need as many pins as I can grab.
Just my colour, I think. Brilliant. Now let's get out before we get caught. Your number leg ain't changed. Let's go and see Zayn Malik's cosmetics. Tongs, an afro comb, wipes, hair dryer. Two of the same hairbrush.
Very nice.
Boys' room. This is not the sign of a vain person. Contestant in the house is Zayn Malik.
Harry, Harry, Harry! What a shocker! And who'd have thought Zayn was that vain, even though Zayn rhymes with vain? Can I just say, one of the cameramen found this compact in the men's toilets. I think it's your powder, Zayn. And whose bra was that? Whose bra was that on Harry's head? Rebecca, I do apologise.
Well, you know what? Because I believe in them so much, and I think they have the potential to be so, so great as a whole together. Mm? One Direction.
Ah, oh, you need to. Well, it's kind of good. She's saying.
And Bellamy. Ah. Girl power all the way. Come on now.
Definitely. Talking of girl power. One Direction, and this has been sent in from Maria, who's from Richmond. I love you boys. I think that your band is a hot one. I think there's a hunky boy, a cool boy, a smart one, and a cheeky one. But who is the not so good looking one?
Oh. Oh. No.
Connie, you make that decision.
You're all equally handsome.
Now, if you haven't made your mind up yet. I don't blame you. 16 acts, very difficult. Maybe this will help. Performing together for the first time, please welcome the X Factor finalists. Download all the contestants' performances from both tonight and last night from iTunes. Go to itv.com.
Potentially, you could be the next big boy band.
It was brilliant, guys.
That was unbelievable.
Absolutely amazing. Welcome back to the X Factor. Lines are closed and the results are in. So, it's time to find out who is safe and who is not. Let's welcome back the judges and the contestants. Cheryl and the girls. Rebecca, Cher, Katie and Tracy. Danny and the boys. Matt, Paige, Niccolo and Aiden. Over 28, John, Storm, Mary and Wagner. And finally, Simon and the Groups. FYD, Bellamy, Diva Fever and One Direction. OK, it's time for the results. So, two acts will be leaving the competition tonight. Here's how it's going to work. I'm now going to reveal which 13 acts are safe and which acts are in the bottom three. The act with the lowest public vote will then leave the competition immediately, and the two remaining acts will compete in the final showdown. Good luck to everyone. So, in no particular order, the first two acts returning next week are... Thank you. Tracy. And John. Also through to next week's show are... Aiden... and Diva Fever.
Oh, my God, I didn't get it out.
The next two acts safe... and definitely returning are... Cher... and Storm.
Yes! Yes! Yes!
Also through and returning next week are... Safely through to next week's show. Remember, this is in no particular order. The ninth act voted into next week's show is... Wagner! The tenth act returning next Saturday is... Returning to sing on this stage next week is... Mary! Congratulations, Louis. All Louis's acts safely through. The 12th act through to next week's show is... One Direction.
Harry Styles.
Ah! Yeah. What a good role model to have. Do you like his style?
Yeah, it's cool. Well,
I think that's a yes. We've also got a phone call from One Direction right now. Are you there, Neil?
Hiya, yeah, hi, Tony.
Hiya, you're through to the lovely boys from One Direction.
Hiya, I just need to ask, Simon said you'd messed up a little bit last night. What happened? I never noticed anything.
Gosh, we didn't hear you. Can you say that again?
Simon said that you'd messed up a little bit last night, and I never noticed anything. What happened?
Yeah, Simon did say that you'd messed up last night.
It was on the stage, it's really, really hard to hear your music and timing.
Like in the studio.
We don't know where it came from, but someone just went out of time, so you just had to pick it back up. Because you can just about hear it, but the music and everything's so hard. I mean, everybody here will tell you. Yeah. So hard.
It was so well dealt with, because no one I knew noticed either. So well done. Boy, Simon shouldn't have even mentioned it, should he? And no one would have known. Yeah. On the gang, this is the moment, I'm afraid, that you are going to learn to dread. Earlier in the week, you were all interrogated about each other. We then put the results together into our big melting pot, mixed it around with the Extra Factor audience's entertainment. We have named this item the Exterrogator.
In the studio, no one can hear you scream.
Who do you want to kiss?
Start singing, birdie.
Probably be one of the Bellamy girls. Which one? Probably Geneva. She's got those big...
F.Y.D.
Hey, Harry.
Mary Byrne.
I think I'd like to kiss Storm.
Aiden.
Because he's pretty.
Definitely Katie Weisel.
Katie Weisel.
Niall from One Direction.
I'd most like to kiss Mary.
I think I've already kissed Mary.
Have you?
Hold on.
That already?
Yeah.
I've kissed Mary.
Who would sell a kiss and tell?
I reckon that Zayn would probably sell a kiss and tell story because he's an ickle flirt.
Harry.
Niccolo.
That's probably got to be Niccolo.
Mary.
Mary Bourne.
It's got to be a good one, though.
Well, yeah, I bet it would be Katie Weisel.
Definitely be Katie Weisel.
There's so much trust in the house. We all love each other. We get along so well. So I really cannot see that happen. Katie Weisel.
Interesting.
Next week. Right now it's time for a break.